Hey YouTube, welcome to another video on knowledge management. I want to address the elephant in the room, and that is Tana. There's a lot of hype around this note-taking tool, and I'm here to answer one simple question. How good is Tana as a knowledge management and note-taking tool? Like most, I had to get in queue to get access to Tana. I finally got access at the end of last year, and I've been using it as my main task management system and experimenting with some Zettelkasten type or knowledge garden style system. I have to say that I'm often overwhelmed, yet quite excited. In today's video, I'll try and decipher the secret sauce of what makes Tana so great and hopefully give you an idea if Tana is the tool for you. Let's take a look. One common way of working with PKM apps is to use the daily note as a hub for all incoming content. This has been popularized by apps like Logseq and Rome, as you're brought into the daily note when you started the app. With a system using nodes, the daily note is a launching point for all your content. In Tana, however, organizing your notes created under the daily note happens naturally with the power of the super tagging system. It doesn't really matter where you create the note, as the tagging system will take care of the organization for you. Nodes are not a new idea in the PKM space. Apps like Logseq, Rome, and Workflowy also built using the node structure. Think of nodes as a tree, a root node and its children nodes like branches reaching out in different directions. There's a reason why the nodes are becoming a popular choice for knowledge tools. This is because they provide an amazing amount of flexibility. Let's take a look at how you can move your nodes around. Nodes can be easily referenced anywhere in the system. Copy a link to a node and paste it anywhere using Ctrl or Command V. The pasted node is then indicated with a circle with a dashed line. This indicates that the node resides somewhere else than its reference place. You can move the node to a new location or make a separate copy of the node using Shift Command V. You can add a link to any node using the @ sign. This creates an inline reference to the linked node. Then easily open up the linked node in line using Shift Click and edit the node without navigating out of the context you're in. This form of blocked embed helps you move content around without breaking the original structure. The command line Command K is there to help you navigate the complexities and initiate any action on the current node. Set an alias to a linked node using the command tool. The aliases are currently limited to a few symbols, but are nevertheless useful when you have longer text node. This is the power of the node structure in a knowledge management context. A node under any hierarchical structure can also be detached from the hierarchy. Nest these under any node, and by pressing Option Command down arrow, this creates a node that is visually linked but is not nested under its parent node. I have an example where I've created a flashcard under a literature node. I don't want the flashcard to be a child of the literature node, but it's easier to create the flashcard in the same space or context. I therefore create a contextual node that extracts the flashcard from the parent node. The potential is crazy. You can create permanent nodes under literature nodes without them linking together as parent and child nodes. So the malleability of nodes is amazing in Tana, but it's Tana's tag system that brings it to the next level. If you're enjoying this video, consider clicking like, as it really helps the channel out. Thank you. There are a lot of new terms being invented to try and decipher the mechanics of the app. One of these terms is super tags. Super tags are what provide Tana the backbone or structure, as well as its flexibility. Super tags are not your typical tags in that they have a super ability. You can insert structure into the tag itself. A super tag can be added to any node. The node is then applied a template predetermined in the super tag settings. Under the hood can be added metadata and any other information that is shared by any node tagged with a specific super tag. Think of them like a combination of database, like in Notion, and templates you see in many note-taking tools. Simple example is creating a daily note template. Each day is assigned the hashtag day super tag. Configure the super tag and add any custom fields into the super tag template field. In this example, there are three different types of information in the template. A custom query that searches for all nodes that are tagged with hashtag task and are not checked. A database field that can be queried separate from the tag content, and any tiles or predetermined structure you want to create. I can conduct a search for any node anywhere with the hashtag task, and it will display all my undone tasks in a list or a table or even a Kanban board. This will display my tasks every day at the top of my daily feed, structured in a way that fits my workflow best. The great thing about super tags is that you can edit and remove any tags in your system without losing any nodes. So restructuring your system is effortless. This is what makes Tana so special. The malleability of the system is on a different level. I would argue that the most important feature of a note-taking tool is the ability to easily resurface your notes in a system. This is where the strength of Tana shine. In addition to a traditional search bar with a good keyword search, Tana has incorporated what they call a live query. This is something similar to Logseq's or RemNodes queries. Initiate the search using the command line and find nodes with tag. The query can then be edited in line, and there are a bunch of filtering, sorting, and grouping options like you might see in Notion, for example. What makes the live query so powerful is the ability to create custom views and add these views into super tags. Then I've created something quite unique and special in the space. That said, there are a few things to keep in mind when making a choice. The product is still in alpha development, and if you're lucky enough to get an invite, there is already a preliminary pricing model of $10 a month or $100 a year presented on their site. The second qualm is that your information is stored in the cloud. If you want your files locally, you have to look elsewhere. You have the possibility to export your notes in JSON format. This then would require some parsing to translate to other systems that use Markdown, for example. Finally, Tana is missing any visual tools like graphs and the canvas that Obsidian have, and it's definitely not the greatest tool for freeform writing. So not a one-size-fits-all solution. I believe that Tana has given us something new and refreshing, a tool that really evolves as you use it. It provides structure created by the user for the user's needs. And I noticed also that I focus more on the working and less on the tool itself. And this is something I've struggled with other PKM tools out there. Now, don't get me wrong, I'm often trying out new systems, refreshing my tags, but as the structure is already there, it prompts you to actually get the work done. Learning to use Tana requires a shift in the way we think about traditional note-taking mechanics. It's simple and intuitive to a point, but gets very complex quickly as you go down the rabbit hole of its potential. But I believe this is a strength, as you can start out simple and then build on more complexities as you learn the system. With all that said, I am super excited about the future of Tana as a PKM tool. There is so much to cover in the app, so I've collected a bunch of creators and some resources down in the description below if you want to learn more about the tool. I also want to hear from you what your favorite PKM tool is and why in the comments below. If you found this video entertaining or useful, consider clicking like. If you want more content like this in the future, subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Bye.